So I've been trying to catch a lift here the entire day, but nobody wants to stop. You know what? I'm just gonna jump into a car. Woohoo! Hey guys, it's Jordy here for CineCam.net, and welcome again to our weekly series Copycat Friday. Now, we have recreated the magical effect from Zack King several times before on the channel, and it has always been so much fun to do. We also get so many reactions asking to recreate more stuff from Zack King. So here we are, let's recreate the hitchhike effect. But first, let's take a brief moment for our sponsor, Videoblocks, who have been making it possible for almost 2 years that we can continue making these videos for you. Videoblocks is a huge library for any filmmaker, as you can always find some stock clips, After Effects templates, or other visual effects to download. It's a community-driven library, meaning that you can become a contributor or download the assets from other users. There's only a single price per year, and 100% of the revenue goes to creators. You can click the first link in the description below to learn more. So this is what we're gonna need, a tripod and a camera. And that's it, let's get going.
And a car, because it's a trick with a car, obviously.
And for those who are wondering, this right here is our custom built GH5 rig. If you wanna see all of the parts that we used right here, well, you can find a link to them in the description below. We thought it would go easy, but ended up driving back to the location 5 times. You really need to try to jump on the same spot as where the car would drive by. Sometimes I would jump too high or not far enough, so keep in mind to film several takes so that you have enough choice in post-production. Later, we also found out that Zack King did not take 2 shots, but actually 3 shots. We had the idea to jump up when the car passed by, and this definitely works, but in order to get the transition more natural, there's a better way. So you have the shot of yourself jumping onto the street. Then Jannik would drive by without me in the car, and then we would drive by again with me in the passenger seat. Now you can see here that I'm leaning outside of the car and pull myself back in as we reach the spot where I jumped. Only in this final shot, you can let the camera pan with the car. So we end up with 3 shots. Now let's bring them into Adobe Premiere Pro after this.
I'll give you $5 if you eat it. Do it for the viewers.
It's
Do
protein.
It for the clicks.
It's protein.
I want to get 1 million views on this video, Lorenzo. Eat the buck.
We're gonna start off by placing the shot of only Jannik driving the car to the first track. Next to that, I'll place the shot of Jannik passing with also myself in the passenger seat. You want to trim these 2 clips so that they perfectly match together. Now bring your jump clip on top of that. With it selected, head over to the opacity property and click the pen tool to draw a mask around yourself. It's best that you start masking on the last frame where you take up the shape of sitting in the car. Enable the animation now for the mask path and adjust your mask as you're going backwards. It takes some time, but that's often the case with such masking tricks. In an interview by Zack King, he once said that he would work for an entire week on one single effect. Now, when you're not covering the entire car anymore, you can make your mask bigger and even more rough as the 2 clips share the same background. The last few frames where you enter the car needs to have a better transition. So add a cut a little before the clip ends. I'm going to trim the clip a little open and add another cut from where I started trimming. The right clip now is going to get a frame hold, which you can set by right-clicking onto it. Now select the 2 last parts, right-click again, and choose Nest. On this nested sequence, I'm going to apply the transform effect to create an animation with the position of the nested sequence, as you want to steer your movement to the exact spot of where you sit in the car. I'm disabled to use the composition shutter angle for the transform effect and set one of your own to get a natural motion blur in that animation. And this is also the reason why we animated the position with the transform effect. Next, right click on the nested sequence and nest it again. There's a conflict in Premiere with masks and the transform effect, which is why you need to nest it so often. On the new nest, I'm going to add another mask. This time it can be rough, and you want to cut off certain body parts that should have entered the car already. Animate this mask as well as you're going through the door of the car. The whole animation process should be done now. We're going to do a few more tweaks to sell the effect even better. Now using Lumetri, I'm going to animate the exposure to make myself darker as I come closer to the car. This is because the car is blocking the sunlight and so I move into the shadow. Now speaking of shadow, since I masked myself out, my own shadow is gone. And to fix this, go to the point where your shadow disappears. There I'm going to add a black color mat on top. With the pen tool, I draw a mask that has the same shape as my shadow. Then start animation for the mask path and change the shape over time as it follows my movements. Then decrease the opacity of that solid and add a little feather into the mask. With Lumetri, you can color grade that solid if you need a little blue tone into it. For the final touch, I'm nesting the whole timeline together, and on that group, I will add a fake handheld camera motion preset to it. And this will take the edge off that static tripod shot. And this is, by the way, a free preset which you can download from our website, cinecom.net. There's also a direct link in the description below. Woohoo! And that was it again. The next time that you need a lift, don't waste time and just jump into a passing car. Thank you guys so much for watching. And by the way, if you want to see some more behind the scenes, then make sure to follow us on Instagram. Thank you, Vidoblog, for support as well. And like always, stay creative.
What a beautiful day here in Belgium. Janik, are you still walking around with your monitor?
It's so pretty.
Lorenzo, you too?
Of course, I got a new BenQ monitor.
What's up with all these monitors? Where's my monitor? Guys, come on, guys.